I?
Well, well. It appears as though the Prince of Slumber will be granting us an audience. How are you feeling, Your Highness?
Ugh, my head. I had a dream. I'm okay. Thanks for coming, Lydia.
Good afternoon, Mr. Neuer. I am Alexander Laskin. I work for the Husha family.
He's the one who found you.
Oh, thank you very much, Mr. Laskin. Without you, I don't know.
The pleasure is mine. You see, I would like to help you find Mr. Sebastian. I need to know what happened to him and to my wife.
Of course. I'm feeling much better. In fact, I was considering leaving here as soon as possible, and...
Daniel, the doctor said you need complete rest. Complete.
I'm fine, really. I found this. Apparently, Husha received a music box from an acquaintance of his, a certain Mr. Farber. It seems as though he was researching the music box when he vanished. And from what Farber says, the music box may be related to everything that has happened.
I'm not sure we should stick our nose into this business after everything that's occurred.
She may be right, Daniel. I'm sure the police are very close to finding out where Husha is.
Do you think the police would have found me? We need to find Husha. I saw the box that Farber describes in this letter, but it wasn't really there. It was as if it were on the other side of... Oh. I think we should pay a visit to this Farber and ask him about the music box and Husha. He has a shop in the city not far from here.
Daniel, please.
I'm fine, really. I think going to a shop and asking the owner a few questions falls within the range of what we can do, don't you?
Weird. It's not like Dad to leave the lights on after closing up. Where did everyone go? Dear Mum Clumsy. Well, I could get there from the store using the basement stairs. What the hell? That door is reinforced with steel. I doubt I could hear anything on the other side. It's gone now. But how did it get in there in the first place? Here you are. Who? Right.
Yes. Mm-mm.
Somebody threw something away in the waste paper basket. It's really freaky. The room is empty. I don't know what else I was expecting. Thank you. Christ, something's wrong. Dad, where in the world have you gone? I don't remember leaving the lights on. Anyway, let's see how much of a mess the house was left in this time. I could have broken my legs. Yes. Good. Again.
Thank you.
Okay. Let's see whether I'm able to follow the bloody trail. Wardrobe that Dad cleaned off in the courtyard. What's that tape doing here?
It's gone. The box isn't here. I've got it. I've had it all this time. How could it be possible? What the devil is happening to me? I have to get to my office. I must wrap it and send it to its owners. LeGrand Amsberg. They're the ones who... My office. I'm going to... I hear them crawling all over and screaming. Erica, come to my office. We'll all be there.
In the office and you're not... Dad. Let's see if I can open it with this. Oh no. No! Dad! Dad!
There was Father. God. I don't even want to think about what must have happened in his final moments. As he was hanging from that noose with the bloody music box on the table next to him. I don't want to think about it, but somehow, very deep within me, I know the song was playing throughout his agony, stalking him to the very frontier between life and death. God. At least we had found the music box, and we knew where it came from. The Grant Amesburg Auction, it said, on the list of product lots, alongside an address. According to Husha, things had improved after returning the box to Faba. So by returning it to its owner, perhaps we might be able to solve all this. It sounded unlikely, but considering my hallucinations, the things we found at the antique shop, and Mr. Faba's terrible end, if it could all come to some good, we had to try it. Isolated far from the world, in a holiday manor that must be about 100 years old, the lady who owned the sinister box awaited us. For my little Ariadne read the engraving on the inside of the cover. Good. Good for her, then.
That someone could actually live in this place?
I don't know. The papers from the auction stated that the owner had sold most of her furniture, but that she still lived here. Mr. Grant? Hello? This place gives me the creeps. Hello? Are you Miss LeGrant? Ariadne LeGrant?
Amesburg?
Pardon me?
LeGrant Amesburg. It's hyphenated.
Oh. Well, my name is Daniel Neuer, and I work for a publishing firm. Through a series of chance occurrences, I found something I believe is yours. It seems crazy, but when you listen to it...
That's its box.
No. I think it belongs to you. On the cover, it says...
I wasn't speaking to you. Thank you for bringing it back, Mr. Neuer. Have you listened to it?
Yes.
He has listened to it.
Oof. Death.
Just what I was thinking. Let's get out of this place.
Absolutely. I'm glad we got rid of that thing.
Me too. I'm sorry it wasn't in time to...
I know. Thanks.
Come on. I'll take you to the shop. Thanks for letting me sleep here.
Of course. Whatever you need. I'll even let you sleep on the couch.
It's more than enough. I just need a couple of nights. That will suffice. I don't feel like staying in an empty house after everything that's gone on.
You can stay as long as you want. Seriously.
Thanks.
At least I know you won't drink my wine.
Very funny. Hey, Sophie?
Oh, no.
Daniel, are you all right?